This is Karutura, which in Oshiraro loosely translates to the place where people do not want to live. Karutura was created in 1961 following the forced removal of Windhoek's black population from the old location, which afterwards was developed into the suburb of Auckland Park. While driving through the streets of Karutura, we met Alan Kamutwedu, born in Karutura 50 years ago, a historian to his community, and he narrated the story of growing up in a political environment.
It was a very difficult time. So sometimes I can remember very well, we went to Independence Stadium today. On our time, we call it Tartanban. So now from there, we don't have left to come back home. So we have to walk back home. So it was beginning little bit dark. And then these guys, the white people came out and asking us, where are you coming from? Ah, we are coming from this Tartanban. This time of the day, make sure before 7 o'clock you are out of this township. So what we have to do now, we have to run from there and to Karutura.
He first takes us to house number 2605. Situated in Soweto's Hendrik Isaac Street, the first house to be built in 1980. It belongs to Lazarus Martin Shipanga, who moved to Luxury Hill 2 years later. The house was then occupied by Fano Moya's family in 1982. Moya and his wife have since died, and during our visit, our news team only found their son, Chodongoro Moya, who was 6 years old back in 1982. Karutura also lacked medical facilities and its first pharmacy, Independence Pharmacy, whose name is self-explanatory, opened its doors in 1991. The pharmacy is housed in the Black Chain complex along the Independence Avenue, which was recently given a facelift and houses different shops, banks, financial services that were added, simply bringing service closer to the people. Black Chain was in the olden days a chain of small shops owned by black people. Kamutwedu then took our news team to this building along the Independence Avenue in Karutura, which had small shops that were owned by some notable personalities in the area. One of them was late Clemens Kapoor, the president of DTA, and it was here, where we stand, Kapoor was shot and killed in 1978. It started as a place where they do not want to live, but once you explore it further, it has become home with a unique culture that brings all together, irrespective of social class. Kapana.